Sexual reproduction in flowering plants. Do you know where the reproductive parts of a plant are located? The reproductive parts of the plant are located in the flower. Here is a flower. Let us identify the reproductive parts in it. Before that, if you have not subscribed to our channel, please subscribe and press the bell icon to get all latest updates. Let us look at the reproductive parts inside the flower. This is the female reproductive part of the plant. It is called pistil. It has three parts: stigma, style, and ovary. These are the male reproductive parts. It is called stamen. It has two parts: anther and filament. Do you think flowers of all plants have both the male and female parts? No. In plants like watermelon and papaya, the flowers are unisexual. That means male and female flowers are separate. Whereas in plants like hibiscus and mustard, the flowers are bisexual. That means a flower with both male and female parts. What do these reproductive parts do? They produce the reproductive cells or germ cells. Anther is the part where male reproductive cells are produced. It produces pollen grains that are yellowish in color. Each pollen grain contains two germ cells and one pollen nuclei. The ovary contains ovules. Each ovule consists of female reproductive cell or egg cell. You know that fertilization means fusion of male and female gametes. Then, how do these male and female gametes come together for fusion? For that, the male gametes should reach the female gametes. But how do the pollen grains travel from anther to stigma? They travel from anther to stigma by the help of air, water, insects, birds, and other animals. The transfer of pollen from stamen to pistil is called pollination. If it occurs in the same flower or between the flowers of same plant, it is called self-pollination. If pollination takes place between two flowers of different plants, it is called cross-pollination. The pollen grains produced by the anther are transferred to the stigma of the pistil. The pollen grain germinates and produces a long tube called pollen tube into the style to reach the ovule. The pollen nucleus and two germ cells travel through the pollen tube and fertilizes the egg. After fertilization, the zygote divides several times to form an embryo within the ovule. The petals, sepals, stamens, style, and stigma may shrivel and fall off. The ovule develops into a seed. The ovary grows to form a fruit. If you haven't subscribed to our channel, please subscribe and press the bell icon to get all the latest updates.